Hello, hello. Welcome to 1981 at Terrapin Crossroads. All right, here are some fun facts. In 1981, the Dodgers won the World Series. The Oakland Raiders won the Super Bowl. Sadly, we lost Bob Marley in 1981. On Jerry Garcia's birthday, August 1st, 1981, MTV was born. Video killed the radio star. Video killed the radio star. Howard Stern began his broadcasting career in Washington, D.C. Prince Charles married Lady Di in 1981. Walter Cronkite officially signed off as the anchor of the CBS Evening News, and Dan Rather took over. Simon and Garfunkel reunited to perform the concert in Central Park. John Hinckley shot and wounded Ronald Reagan. The AIDS epidemic was formally recognized by medical professionals in San Francisco. And lastly, Warner Brothers Records raised the price of a 45 single from $1.68 to $1.98. In the movies, Chariots of Fire won the Oscar for Best Picture. Other great movies that year were Raiders of the Lost Ark, On Golden Pond, Arthur, and of course our buddy, our Grateful Dead buddy, Bill Murray's movie Stripes. On TV, we had Dallas, The Jeffersons, Three's Company, MASH, and The Dukes of Hazzard. In the Billboard Top 10, Just Like Starting Over from John Lennon was still there. Sadly, he was killed just about a month earlier in the beginning of the year. The Tide is High by Blondie, Celebration by Kool and the Gang, Keep on Loving You by REO Speedwagon, Rapture by Blondie, Kiss on My Lips by Hall & Oates, Physical by Olivia Newton-John, Private Eyes by Hall & Oates, Jesse's Girl by Rick Springfield, and of course the one-hit wonder Betty Davis Eyes by Kim Carnes. All right, in Grateful Dead land in 1981, they played, I believe it was 82 shows. Pretty typical about that time. Althea was still the number one most played song at 44 that year. There were 24 China Riders, 23 Let It Grows, 23 Scarlet Begonias, but only 4 Uncle John's bands. 1 Ripple and 1 Dark Star. They played the whole range of venues. They played small theaters like the Uptown in Chicago, which is like a Warfield-sized theater, and they also played Madison Square Garden and the Nassau Coliseum. The Madison Square Garden's March 9 and 10, I believe, is what Rob Eaton was saying earlier. That was my 100th Grateful Dead concert, March 9th. I think everyone would agree that as they were rolling into 1981, the band was very strong. Their playing was still great. They were still cooking with Brent. But there was a transition coming. First I'm going to talk about one thing that happened in 81. Phil's going to tell us just a short story about the Oops concert, which happened in Amsterdam, correct?
Yeah, so we were on tour in Europe, and we had just played Copenhagen. And all Rock Scully comes in and says, "Man, they canceled some gigs on us." Like, I guess, I don't know where it was.
France.
France?
Again, France, the canceled
French
shows.
Yeah. Anyway, not. So they canceled these gigs in France, and so we had some free time that we didn't know what to do with. So I knew what I was going to do. I was going to go back to Copenhagen and hear the Vienna Philharmonic under Leonard Bernstein play Brahms. So I went and did that. But then the rest of the guys went to Amsterdam and decided they'd just play a spontaneous gig. So after I went and saw the Philharmonic, I came back to Amsterdam and we played one of the famous clubs in Amsterdam, Milky Way. The other one was Paradiso. It was like, those were the hash bars in 80s Amsterdam, the big deal. Everybody in the world knew about those two clubs, all the heads anyway. And it was always, and they had been, how long had the hash been in weed been illegal in Amsterdam at that point?
That I do not know.
Anybody? But it was a while. it had been going on for a while, because I remember in the 60s, we heard about these places, and it was like, oh, God, we got to go there, you know. But it was a really kind of funky place. And
400
the
people.
The gig was kind of funky, too, because everybody was playing on borrowed instruments, except me. I brought my bass with me. Just in case, you know.
So while they were on tour, they toured twice in Europe in 81, once earlier in the year, I think it was spring, and then the show we just talked about was in the fall. On one of those European trips, there was a little bit of a falling out between a band member and their manager at the time, Richard Lauren, and he was fired briefly, and he was brought back in, and then he quit later in the year. And at that point, the band decided they were going to manage themselves. And so... Tell us a little bit about what it felt like in 1981. You know, at this point, you're 16 years into your career, and you're gonna buck the trend in the music industry and manage yourself. And you had a big staff. And how did everybody feel about that situation?
I don't really remember, but I'm sorry, man, I don't. But what I do remember is that we just had it with. Taking advice from other people, I don't know. It probably had a lot to do with all the cocaine that was going around. Cause we were getting a little aggressive, you know. and so we just decided, fuck this. We're gonna make our own decisions, you know. So
the captain of your own trip.
We started having endless meetings, of course, as a result of that. Beyond that point, we were spending more time in meetings than I think we were on stage playing music, and we weren't really very good at it, but we managed to stumble through somehow until at some point. We hired them another manager.
I think Rock actually came on back. And Rock Scully, who was their original manager, I think he was working during this whole period, but not as the official manager. So they had some people that had taken them out on the road. So you had some direction.
We had somebody, you know.
You had
to
a
help
second
us out
in command.
With this, but,
sort of a ship's captain.
But during this same time, we were kind of getting more and more isolated from one another off stage. And it was kind of disturbing, and in meetings, everything, it was like very contentious, and cocaine again, partly responsible. and so the only thing that was really holding us together at that point was what we could do on stage, and thankfully, that had not been. Eroded by the cocaine and all of that, so it was still powerful enough, the bond between us musically, so that I could walk out on stage every night and know that the infinite possibilities that were always there waiting for us, we had the capability to grasp that, just simply by walking out there and playing music like we always do, because as soon as the music starts, your ego disappears, and you can be there, and you know, take it to the highest level. And so that was the saving grace at that period.
And I think from what I've understood and from music, I went to a bunch of those shows in '81. That conversation on stage led to some pretty spectacular jams in between the songs.
Yeah, and that was when it started to live the music started to live in those moments between the songs and the transitions, and that was where the real conversation could take place. And like I say, the goal was always to make every place we played into a shrine to expanded consciousness, or church, if you will. So, and we were still able to do that.
The music always wins. All right, so I have some parting words from Mr. Jerry Garcia. So after they started managing themselves and they're having these endless meetings, Jerry came to one of those meetings with a little thing that he had written that sort of summarized how he was feeling about the situation of the band taking over these management duties, and this is directly from Jerry Garcia, and he says, Grateful Dead Productions Incorporated is a legal fiction, not a working reality. It does not represent our real work. Just because we have an office doesn't mean we have to feel we have to be office workers. Nor need we identify ourselves as a corporation because we have a corporation. We need to liberate ourselves from misunderstanding ourselves. We need to protect ourselves from believing that we are essentially a corporate entity. The reason for this attempt to describe ourselves is to free all the people in our organization from having to feel defined by what is actually an externally dictated fiction of convenience. Jerry Garcia. All right, we have a great show for you tonight. You're gonna really dig it. It's a great set list, it was a great show. You'll figure out what it is soon enough. Thanks for coming to 1981, and we'll see you soon here at Terrapin Crossroads. Thanks, everybody.
the heart of town. Tell her this town ain't got no heart. Just gotta poke around. Girl is shaking on Shakedown Street. Used to be the heart of town. Tell her this town ain't got no heart. You just gotta poke around. Be the heart of town.
Be the heart of town.
Tell me this town ain't got no heart.
This town ain't got no heart.
Just got poke around.
Got poke around.
Just got poke around.
Tell me this town ain't
got no heart.
Just got poke around.
Just got poke around.
Just got poke around.
Thank you.
this town ain't got no heart. You just gotta poke around. Nothing's shaking on Shakedown Street. Used to be the heart of town. Don't tell me this town ain't got no heart.
Got no
heart. You just gotta poke around.
You just gotta poke around.
Just gotta poke around.
Thank you. Texas, down of El Paso, I fell in love with a Mexican girl. Now time would find me in a Rose's Cantina, music would play, Felina would twirl. Black as the night were the eyes of Felina, wicked and evil while casting her spell. I was in love with this Mexican maid. I was in love, but in vain I could tell. But not a wild young cowboy came in. Wild as the West Texas wind. Dashing and daring, and drink he was sharing with wicked Felina, girl that I love. So in anger, I challenged the rifle, the love of the his mate, out with his hands for the guns that he wore. Down to the dancer in less than a heartbeat, the handsome young stranger lay dead on the floor. Just for a moment, I stood there in silence, shocked by the valuable deed I had done. Thoughts raced through my mind as I stood there. I had one chance, and that was to run. Out through the back door, rolling down, ran out with the horses been tied. Now I picked a good one. He looked like he could run. Well, up on his back and away I did ride, just as fast as the West Texas town of El Paso, out through the badlands of New Mexico. Back in El Paso, life could be worthless. Everything's gone and left, nothing is new. It's been so long since I've seen the young man. My love is stronger than my real day. Feel a bullet go deep in my chest. From out of nowhere, Felina has found me, kissing my cheeks as she kneels by my side. Cradled by two loving arms that I'll die for, one little kiss and Felina, good.
Thank you. rain. If you hear that same sweet song again, well, you know why. Passing by.
don't you cry anymore.
Slept by the silver sea. I can tell by the mark he left you were in his dream. Oh, child of countless trees. Oh, child of boundless sea. What you are, what you're meant to be. Speaks deceived God's own design. Nothing to tell me, let the words be yours, I'm done. Very well now, let your life perceive God's own design. Nothing to tell me, let the words be yours, I'm done. Thank you.
With the iodine.
Out of bed, the covers were still warm, but where you've been laying, now you were gone, oh, and my heart was filled with dread. Might not be sleeping here again. But it's all right, 'cause I love you. That's not gonna change. You run me round, make me good. Again and again. But I'll still sing you love song written in the letters of your name. Will you pray that storm to come? For it surely looks like rain. Ever wake to the sound of street cats making love, and I guess from their cries you enlisted to a gun. Only trying to make it through the night. Thank you. landscape would be empty if you were gone. Well, it's all right, 'cause I love you. That's not gonna change. Run me round, you make me hurt again and again. You pray that stone to come down, for it surely looks like rain. When it looks like rain, oh, pray that stone to come. Well, here comes a rain. Said it looks like rain and it feels like rain all over. Here comes the rain. Said it looks like rain and it feels like rain all over. Here comes the rain. It looks like rain and it feels like rain. Oh, oh now. Now here comes the rain. Well, rain, rain, I'll go away. Come back another day, turning my whole world gray. It looks like green, feels like green, all oh, no, now. Here comes the rain. Pray that storm to come. Looks like green, feels like green, all oh, no, now. Here comes the rain. Well, my whole world's turning green. Looks like green.
Thank you.
coyote drip of silver. Kimono like the crazy. We'll start down the tree like.
but I could not take my rest. Lay down last night, Lord, I could not take my rest. My mind was wandering like a wild geese in the
thank you. your heart.
Grab that. Thank you.
the direction she was calling my eye. Could be an illusion, but I might as well try.
Thank you. Thank you. Paradise, you know I'm gonna shine. You're gonna see.
know her. Now, 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 how do we go?
summer home. Ain't got time to call you, it's all our critic know. Right outside the lazy gate, winter, summer home.
You are the song that the morning brings.
your home. Sometimes we ride on your horses, sometimes we walk alone. Sometimes the songs that we hear are just songs.
Thank you.
but I got some time to hear his story. My name is August West, and I love my pearly baker best more than my wife. Friend of mine. Everyone says I come to no good. I knew I would barely believe them. Spent doing time for some other fucker's crime. The other half found me stumbling around, drunk on burgundy wine.
Get up and fly away.
to hear. I said to him, I'm sure she's been. I said to him, I'm sure she's been true to
Joe, it was Joe.
crazy sound. But no, they never stopped rocking till the moon went down. Oh, it sounded so sweet, I had to take me a chance. Roll, who's out of my seat now? I just had a day. I started moving my feet. Oh, yes, I clapped my hands. We'll be right back. in comes all the news. So they gave no satisfaction. It's wild, sing the blues. It's finally looking crazy. You notice what to do. They got my low and joy. They got your right to the. When it's Saturday night, with a hug. One more Saturday night. Saturday night. Golly, yep, I never thought we would be this good. But how I'm being a party for the public good. Don't worry about tomorrow, won't you know when it comes. We're rocking golden music, it's love and shine and sun.
Hey, thanks for coming out one more time and joining us on our journey through time. If there's any kind of a time warp happening in the world, this is probably it. Anyway, thanks again for coming out. As always, it's a bittersweet moment for me. I get to play music with these great players because I'm alive to do so, and I'm only alive to do so because Cody got up one day and told his mom that he wanted to be an organ donor. He saved the lives of 8 people, including me. So without Cody, in a real sense, this place wouldn't exist. And this nation here that we, you know. So I just want to ask you to join me in honoring his courage and his generosity of spirit simply by turning to somebody you love and loves you and tell him, hey, if anything ever happens to me, I want to be an organ donor. It's the simplest thing in the world. Because family is what counts in those very heavy moments. And I'd also like to
invite you all to join us down here at our blood drives. We've been doing pretty, well, not really regular, but frequent blood drives down here. And I just want to urge you all to keep posted. And when you see a blood drive coming up, come on down and give blood, because blood's as important as anything else in the medical situation today. So God bless you. Thank you for listening. We got a couple more for you.
Highway is for gamblers. You better use your
from your streets. It's drawing crazy patterns on your sheets. The sky too is falling over you, and it's all over now, baby blue.
All righty. All the way over here, Rob Eaton on guitar and vocals. Yeah, Rob Eaton on guitar and vocals. Ezra Lipp on drums. Stu Allen on guitar and vocals. Rob Barraco on keys and vocals. Alex Koford on drums. I'm Phil Lesh. Thank you for joining us. And guess what? We have one more for you.
What's happening? What's happening, Phil?
What's happening, Phil?
We're going to do another song, Bob. I mean, Stu.
Thank you.
gotta have love done. Oh, everybody's got to have love. It's like a friend of mine used to tell me, with that good love, you ain't gonna make it through just one more day. You be good loving. You may be weak and you may be blind.
Even
a blind man knows when the sun is shining. Cause he can feel it now. He can feel it shining down now. Shining, shining strong, shining strong and bright.
Got to have love.
You be good loving.
Got to have
you be
love.
Good loving. Your baby weak and you may be blind, but even a blind man knows when the sun is shining. Cause he can feel it now.
Good
he can feel it now. Shine down, shine in love. Got to have love,
love.
Everybody got to have love,
love.
And I got to have love,
love.
Everybody got to have love,
love.
Go, give them your love,
love.
And I got to have love,
love.
Go on, yeah, love,
love.